Let's stand as we pray together. Lord, we come before you this morning. We thank you that we can gather and we can grieve, and we thank you that you are the God of all comfort. And Lord, I even pray now that you might comfort this dear family and all the friends that are gathered here. And Lord, we just thank you so much for Curtis and for his life. And we pray as we pay tribute now and share memories and the hope that is found in you, O God, that you might be lifted up out of this. And I just thank you again, Lord, that you are the one that can reach the deepest recesses of our hearts today. And as only you can, Lord, you can fix those things and help heal and strengthen and comfort. And so, Lord, we commit this time to you and we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. You may remain standing as we read God's word from Psalm 23. And family requested that we read this. And Psalm 23 is a very familiar psalm, but it is a psalm from the perspective of the living. And it is a psalm, really, that is from a sheep's perspective of the great shepherd. David writes, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." May God add his richest blessing to the reading of his word. You may be seated. At this time, the family has some tributes that they want to pay, family and friends, and I think Avery and Jessica, you're going to be coming up.
Where do I start? Curtis was the most determined and hardworking person I've ever met. His laugh cheered me up, his smile brightened the room, and they were not afraid of a good time. He can honestly say that he lived his best life, whether it was at work welding, working on a truck or a dirt bike, or up at the shed finagling something, washing his red truck that he loved like his baby. Curtis was truly one of a kind. He was extremely intelligent and he knew so much about mechanics. He could see an old car or a truck and tell you all about it. What the year of the vehicle was and the style of it, he could sit in a vehicle and hear the smallest noises and know what was wrong with it instantly. He could take apart a dirt bike and put it back together better than it was before. But although he had a love for mechanics, welding was his passion. He attended the Technology Center at the high school for welding and chose to continue his career at Eastern Maine Community College, achieve all of his certifications and become a traveling welder. That was his dream. He spent his time welding at Alvin Tardif's and Travis Garrett's. Curtis wasn't scared of anything except for spiders. If you attempt him with one, he would well. I would never seen him run away from something so fast. He was fearless when it came to wheeling a dirt bike in his dad's Harley. I've never seen anyone so talented at doing these things. I've never seen someone who was able to wheelie a Harley like he could. He was the happiest when he was on two wheels, in his red truck, or in his Uncle Craig's Nova, which he had gotten to run again after it hadn't been ridden for a while. He was a brave soul and had a bold personality. He was the life of the party anywhere he would go. He had a passion for old vehicles, trucks, and dirt bikes. He always brought things, fixed them up, and sold them again. The truck that he was recently working on was previously in their family. It was Monica's favorite. But when Curtis was really young, they had sold it. He had bought it back and pulled into the garage with it and surprised Mr. Andrew. Over the years, it had taken some beatings and wasn't in great condition, and Curtis was working to fix it up again with his dad. They spent countless hours in the garage together working on his truck and many other vehicles and bikes. His best friend was his mom. always sending her videos and pictures of what he was doing, where he was, and kept her updated on every part of his life. Stealing her adult drinks off the front porch without her knowing, till the next day, he was truly a mama's boy. Jake and Landon, you've helped Curtis live his best life. All the stories I've heard and the memories I have seen of the three of you. Landon, I remember the day we all went riding in the muddy trails. Hour after hours of getting stuck and unstuck, you had blown the chain on your four-wheeler. I remember seeing Curtis's smile and hearing his laugh every time he would grab your shifter and move it just to hear the grinding noise over and over again. Jake, all the shop and saves, freight stories, high school bonfires, dirt bike rides, and that boat you had gotten together. I remember getting stuck in the lake and the motor wouldn't turn back on. Curtis took out the old paddle that was in the side of the boat and tried to paddle us in from the middle of the lake. We ended up having to get towed in. He loved you both with his whole heart, and I have no doubt in my mind that he will be with you guys every step of the way. I've been great friends with Curtis since I could remember. Walking up the path behind the house after soccer practices to walk into the garage working on his snowmobile, or sitting in his folding chair listening to music. He was great at ice skating, as he was at anything that he did. We would race around the ice skating rink to see who was faster, but he'd always have me beat. Walking around town, riding bikes, and stealing cucumbers from Monica's garden. Seeing Curtis, Austin, and Cody, and Cyprin come to music in the park on their tractors, that they had all taken the mowers off, and to see them wheeling the tractors. Who knew? Curtis, Avery, and I had gone to the grocery store one time, and we had only gotten four things: goldfish, ramen noodles, little muffin bites, and more noodles. I couldn't help but laugh when he looked at me in the checkout and said, "What?" with a big smile on his face, because he was proud of all the things that he had picked out because they were all his favorite. I remember how mad he would get driving down my driveway after I'd get a text or a call saying, "I just popped my tire," followed by, "I'm never driving my truck up there again," or him getting frustrated at the bumpy driveway because they would always pop the fender out on the Jeep, or Mr. Andrew didn't want it to get muddy because he had just washed it, but he'd bring it up anyways. I'd go see Avery and tell you that I was going to see my favorite Levesque, but you always had the favorite spot. All the times we'd barge into Avery's room at 3 a.m. and jumping on her for no reason to wake her up and tell her about the night. Hearing you call me feisty woman, the late night pizzas, beers, drives, laughs, and talks. Spending time with our friends, I wish we could go back to those days. You had so much life to live and so many goals to fulfill. I wish we could see you fulfill them. Monica, Mr. Andrew, you raised an amazing young man who had an impact on everyone he met. And we're all gonna miss him. I love you, Curtis. One more ride. Curtis was my brother, my role model, and one of my best friends since before I can remember. He was one of those people who could make anything a good time, whether it was just sitting at the kitchen table talking with mom, or partying it up in Canada or in the middle of the woods somewhere. His laugh was something I don't think any of us will ever forget. He could say or do something not even remotely funny, but just because he was laughing, we had to laugh too. Curtis was so full of life, and I know he wasn't ready to leave us yet, but he made the most of his 19 years here with us. He was up to do anything and had no fears, except spiders. He was terrified of spiders. There are certain memories that have been replaying in my head the past few days, like when he came to pick me up in Fort Kent one night, and we were flying down North Prairie going 70 in a snowstorm. Anyone else would have been holding onto their seat for dear life, but me and Curtis were having our own personal concert, singing songs all the way home. I knew he would get me home safe. I remember one day, we were at the shed when we were young. He was riding his dirt bike and I was on my four-wheeler.
He was coming up the hill as I was turning to go down the hill, so neither of us saw each other, and he ran right into the front of my four-wheeler. He hopped off his bike right away and asked me if I was okay, and then immediately said, "Don't tell Dad." When I first started going to KPL and hanging out with that group of people, he was so mad because he thought I was going to be a snitch and tell my parents everything they did. Little did he know, I knew about the cucumbers from Mom's garden when I was in 7th grade, and I didn't tell anyone. If you know, you know. I could stand here and list every single memory I have with him, but we'd be here for a really long time, so I won't. Curtis was one of a kind, and none of us will ever meet another soul like his, which is why I know he will be remembered by everyone who ever met him. I've spent my whole life with Curtis, and I know it'll be hard to live without someone who's always been around me, but I know he'd want me to have a good time and make sure the Levesque name keeps a good reputation. Curtis, even though you're not here with me, I still believe you can hear me, and this time you won't be able to interrupt me mid-conversation like you always do. You were the best big brother I could have ever asked for. Ever since I was little, whenever I was in trouble, you would be the one to come to my rescue. I'd give anything for you to come barging into my room again at 2 in the morning, whether it was just for you to stare at me with a funny face and then walk out, or to talk to me for hours about everything you did that night. You are one of my favorite people in the entire world, and when someone comes up to me and asks me, "Who are you?" I'll still say I'm Curtis Levesque's little sister like I always do, because I know everyone knows who you are. Nothing will ever be the same without you, but I know you are watching over all of us, and I promise I will make you proud. Make sure to watch over Noah and Mom and Dad. Keep Noah safe, just like you always did with me. I've never really believed in guardian angels, but now I know for sure that I have one. I love you forever and always, Curtie, and I know you'll be